soy, but we're still eating it. That's why, like Alex was saying earlier,
I tell ya,
we're being forced to import soy from Romania.
I'm cutting my fingers up here. When you grow okra, you have to cut it every day. I mean, if you don't cut it like one morning, you have to cut it that afternoon. If you don't cut it that afternoon, the next morning for sure. And we let this go for 2 days. Well, it was a little inclement weather. But like I said, I'm cutting my fingers trying to cut off the pods on top. I'll go over there and show you in a moment. But right here, I have around 75 okra pods. And we've got no more room in our freezer. We've been blanching some of them, vacuum sealing some of them, cutting them in pieces and bagging them and sealing them. And there's just no more room in the freezer. We bought a dehydrator. We go to Aldi's once a month, get 4 cans of sugar, of coffee. That's our one, dirty, whatever, weakness, whatever. But, so I'm going to dehydrate these, man. We can put them in bags, and I got them in totes. I got these, giant totes. I got 3 of them. One of them's got dog food in it, a couple bags of dog food. And I've been putting dehydrated stuff in there. But these are going to be dehydrated with that dehydrator. We bought it at Aldi for $20. That thing has been worth its price in gold. Now, these are cannelli beans. I can't really do this while holding this off. I'm going to see if I can get one. I got one in my pocket. Sorry. See, now, they're going to be like a purple skin color. I'm going to hold this in my mouth. Can you see that? Where is it? I'm looking underneath the crack on the viewfinder. Yeah, you can see that purplish bean? It's like that. 3 of them generally in a pod. And I've got a few of those. These are very hard to grow. I've grown them 3 times. This is the best it's come out. And we thought they were like butter beans. I opened them up and saw those purple beans and then realized those are cannoli beans. But see, I put out this little string work for them to crawl like vines, but this is as big as they got. And I've been picking them now. I got some more I'm going to pick later on, probably this afternoon. It's probably around 1 o'clock in the afternoon right now. It's Monday. But you see these okra here. There's at least 70, probably 75 okra in there. And I mean, these are not too big. They are too big to boil anything like that. That's about 8 inches long. I'm going to cut off that much, cut off the very end, and then I'm going to slice it, and I'm going to dehydrate it. So that'll give me probably 1 gallon, maybe 2 gallon bags full. But they're going to be in a sealer. They're not going to be in gallon freezer bags. We cut the plastic with one of those food sealers. And about I'd say we do about a 2 gallon bag. Well, see, if you do it and then you cut it open, you got to use it up within a certain time. But you can see how the okra looks here. This will produce until mid to late October. You know, it might go a little further with this plastic down. Like I said, this plastic has helped. I even got beans I started again about 3 weeks ago. And there's a cantaloupe over there. Doubt that these are going to produce because the bees and the butterflies have been sticking. You can see a few of them over here on the torch sunflowers, the orange ones. These are mostly died off. I've been cutting these off for seeds. Oh, man. I've got at least a 5-gallon bucket. Well, this will give me a 5-gallon. I got about a half a bucket of these torch sunflowers. These are keep putting out too this year. So the little orange one come up right here. But see the heads? These are the heads. They put out like 4, 5, 6, or 7 or more. I don't even know how many. A lot on each plant. You have one stem and then you have all these hundreds. Look at all of them though. There are hundreds of seeds. Well, I'd say about 40 to 75 seeds on each head. You pluck them out with either tweezers. I kind of like brush them and you'll see them fall on the table and all that, and I put them in these little sandwich bags. I've got one full and another one's already about a third full. And like I say, this is more than enough. I mean, I got enough here to do this entire garden 5 times around. But I'm going to leave this part open next year again. But I'm going to put the torch all the way around this time with the Titan, the big yellow ones. One left over there in the corner behind the black-eyed peas. I've got 3 or 4 black-eyed peas growing, so I got all the diseased ones up. So I'll have, you can see the old sunflowers, those are Titan sunflowers, or I can't remember the other brand. But the Titan ones, that real tall one there, and you see these dead ones here. dying. Those will be all around with those orange ones. It'll look like this with the tall yellow ones in there, the Titans. And the butterflies have been so many. I've had so many monarch butterflies, which are very rare now, but we've had monarchs over here, hummingbirds over here, all the swallowtail butterflies are over here all the time. It's really pretty. And the bees don't bother you. I've walked around them, all that. I've gone here, I bumped the flowers that are on the okra, and you hear them buzzing on it, and they get disturbed sometimes, and they take off. And here's a big okra I didn't cut. Hold on. Okay, that's about 7 inches. I just looked right by here, too. I've been by around this 3 or 4 times. There's still some up there you see up on that top, I think, if I can zoom in. There's an okra somewhere in there. That's about 3 inches, 2.5 inches. They're like that on the tops. But like I said, the bees get in the flowers here. I don't bother. I mean, I disturb them. I don't really bother them, though. But they buzz around, then they leave and they come back. There's another bigger okra right there. I'm just going to leave that tomorrow. I'll probably get that one. I'm supposed to get these at least once a day. Like I say, if you miss them in the evening, then the next morning you should get them. And like we let this go for almost 2 days. And now we've got at least 75 pods. Oh, man. Got rid of the Kmart tomato plants, thank God, finally. All right, so that's just showing you the okra out here. You have to pick them every day. You know, look at how bare they look, but they're still producing okra pods all over. And my black-eyed peas are still producing, and these tomatoes, these big tomatoes. This was the first little tomato plant I put out here. We started in the house. This one and the one behind it. Then I had those four from Kmart. And I think that's where I might have got hookworm from. I don't care why anybody's a hornworm, whatever. But anyway, now they're producing better. The cannoli bean over there. And then these peppers by the house. These are starting to put out now, too. Most of these are bell peppers, you know, or they call them keystone or whatever you want to call them. There's like three peppers on that one. These big ones, one there. We've had a couple hornworms on here. See that one? See how the branches, the leaves are all laid off that bottom there? There was only one leaf on this plant about 2 weeks ago, and we killed that sucker. Didn't even pay attention. Look at this one. Yesterday I noticed it, and I got one hornworm. To see that other one was just like this right here, one leaf on it. And now look at it right there. 2 weeks ago. Oh, right there it is over there. 2 weeks ago. 2 to 3 weeks ago. So this one might come back. I don't know. But hornworms will eat up your garden if you don't take care. But like I said, we walk right by this all the time when we come out here. And I see every time now I see that one, the first one that got the hornworm on it, every time I see that dead branch at the bottom, I'm like, oh, there's a hornworm. But no, we already got that one. So, all right. See if I can go another 2 weeks. It's going to be hard. I just got to keep dehydrating these okra. You know, so we'll have them. This is one of the most nutritious vegetables, too. See this one here? This is about 4 inches, maybe 5 inches. Where is that? I eat this one raw. Yeah, they're good. Trust me, they are good. You can eat them. One of the most nutritious vitamin, vitamin-wise vegetables you could have is okra. I loved these when I was a kid. Never ate them raw until now. But they're good.